In this episode, we talk with national team center John Mann, 2012 Olympic gold medalist Maggie Steffens, and a two-year-old. Next on The Counterattack. Hi everyone, Greg Meskel here. Thanks for joining us on The Counterattack. We start things off with a big event coming to Orange County next week, the FINA Men's Intercontinental Tournament. Corona Del Mar High School will play host to some of the best in men's water polo, and you can be there. Tickets are on sale right now at usawaterpolo.org, or if you can't make it out to Southern California, we'll stream the entire event on USA Water Polo TV on our YouTube channel. Speaking of that event, we're going to talk with a member of the men's national team, Center John Mann, joining us now from a training camp in Colorado Springs. John, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Greg.
John, big event coming up for you and Team USA right in your old backyard, Corona Del Mar High School, the FINA Men's Intercontinental Tournament. Tell me your thoughts as you get ready for this event.
I'm just really excited. It's always fun to come back from playing overseas and meet up with your teammates again and have a chance to improve and win games and be at home and play is another great side of it too. You're going to have some of the most talented teams in the world there and a hungry, young USA team that's looking to take the world by storm and prepare for the Pan American Games this summer.
Well, John Mann and Team USA, hungry in and out of the water, getting ready for the FINA event next week. John, thanks for taking the time. Good luck with the rest of the training this week.
Thank you. Hopefully see you all next week.
So again, a great chance to see John Mann and the rest of Team USA next week, starting on March 30th at Corona Del Mar High School. Come out and join us. We now switch gears to the women's game and some college scores from this past weekend. A lot of the top-ranked squads in action, except number one, UCLA. Some of the games that took place, Arizona State hosting over the weekend, Hartwick topping Long Beach State 7-6, Long Beach State coming back to beat Arizona State 5-3, and then some of the big four, Stanford dominating Harvard 23-7, and USC all over Hawaii 10-1. Our women's national team was also in action this past weekend as they traveled to Italy for a week of common training. They took on the Italians in an exhibition game this past Saturday in Rome, falling 11-9, despite three goals from Melissa Seideman, Carly Capanna going the whole way in net for Team USA. And speaking of the college and the national team game, who better to talk to than Maggie Steffens, 2012 Olympic gold medalist and current starter for the Stanford Cardinal. Maggie joins us on the phone now from Stanford. Maggie, thanks for taking some time today. How are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Doing all right. Can't complain. Maggie, you're obviously in the middle here of your college season. Stanford, once again, a favorite for the NCAA crown, winners last year. Tell me about the year right now. How is your team doing? How are things looking as you look towards the playoffs?
We're really excited. I mean, it's always fun to know that you have the opportunity to play for a championship at home, but we understand it's going to be a long, hard trek get there. There's a lot of good teams this year and a lot of great competition. So, you know, that's what makes it great is knowing that in order to be the best, you got to beat the best. And we're excited to have that opportunity for sure.
Speaking of having fun, last week, something that was a whole lot of fun on our Facebook and Twitter and Instagram pages was a picture of a young two-year-old from Chicago, dubbed the next Maggie Steffens. When you see this photo and you see it retweeting and trending everywhere, what was your thoughts when you saw that?
I wanted to just jump up and cry, and I don't know, it was so cute, but it was also so inspiring that her face was so intense. I was like, wow, here's this little girl who I was exactly like. I was in the water at 2 years old and playing around with my older siblings, and here she was kind of just going for it, like I was saying earlier about Fish and Maddie. So I loved it.
Excellent stuff. Well, Maggie Steffens, good luck with the rest of the college season, and then, of course, what will be a busy summer with Team USA. Thanks for joining us. Well, thanks, Maggie, for joining us. And speaking of that two-year-old girl, she joins us now, Navia Escalante from Chicago. Thanks for coming on The Counterattack. How are you doing?
Good.
Hey, Navia, we saw your picture, and you were looking very, very tough, but can you smile for us?
Smile.
Oh, look at that. Look, she smiles also. So she's a tough water polo player. Now, how about your tough face? Do you have a tough face for water polo?
Game face.
Whoa, that is a game face no one's going to want to mess with. Hey, Dad, you want to slide in there for a minute and talk to us too? This is Navia's dad, Ernesto. Ernesto, tell me about when this photo goes up and you see all the people commenting, what did you think about it when you saw your little girl there?
Yeah, I mean, that was wild. Like, it was just a time that we had to spare at the pool. You know, it was just waiting for our swim to start. We got there a little early, and this photo shoot she took about five photos, but this one was, you know, she did that on her own. I would never think that she would make a face like that, but that's like her demeanor. You know, like that's who Navia is. Like, she's like the bully of the house.
Really? So she runs things over there?
She totally does. I mean, her sister's six years old, and like, she's the boss. You know, Navia just, she is a character. She's different, but.
Sure, sure. Well, the last thing, Navia, what's the one thing we should tell Maggie? Do you want to say hi to her?
Hi, Maggie.
Okay, well, we'll tell Maggie you said hi, and I'm sure she'll say hi back. From Chicago, two-year-old Navia Escalante, the star of our Facebook page from a week ago, thanks so much for joining us. I know we're still early in this program's history, but that might have been my favorite interview of all time. We now turn to some education opportunities, especially for those wearing the whites, the referees. Coach and referee schools are coming up all across the country and in many zones over the next month to 2 months, so make sure you don't miss out on a chance to better your skill. Visit usawaterpolo.org, go under Community, and then click on Coach and Referee Schools, and you'll see a whole bunch are coming up to various zones, the SOPAC Zone, Coastal, Pacific, Pacific Northwest, Central California. Registration open now. These refs, all of you, you're great, but there's always a chance to get better. Don't miss out on this opportunity right here from USA Water Polo. And now we close things out with the social media send-off. A great week for social media, and we're not done with Navia Escalante just yet. Look at this image sent in from Fab Sports. Might be the first two-year-old water polo poster. It's pretty cool, though. The game face, I think we can all agree, is spot on. Thanks for sending that in. And then a dog in a water polo cap. Everyone loves this. Chester Ramos, that's the dog. Armando Ramos, that's the dog's dad, sending in this picture from the Chula Vista Aquatics Club. That dog might be a bit undersized for the 2 meter position, but looks ready to roam the perimeter. Let's get that dog out there and play some water polo. And we want to see more of your submissions. So thanks to everyone for sending in what you have so far. We want to see more. Use the hashtag counterattack. Tweet at us, Facebook us, at USAWP. That'll do it for this episode. Thanks for joining us. You know the drill. When you're on the counterattack, look weak side. Have a good one.
Yes, our little Brunswiger should join.
Five, Akira Yanasi. Six, Yuta Hemi. Seven, Yusuke Shimizu. Eight, Yuki Kirono. Nine, Koji Takai. 10, Kenya Yasuda. 11, Kiego Okawa. 12, Atsuta Lida. 13, Tomiyoshi Fukushima. Head coach, Yoji Moto. Assistant, Takahisa Minami, team leader, Fumitoshi Abe. Wearing the white caps, Kazakhstan. 1, Marekan Mametov. 2, Sergei. Branko Pekovic. 13, Valery Shlemov. Head coach, Sergei Markoch, assisted by Sergei Drozdov. Today's officials, Mr. Mole, Mr. Ortega, and the team delegate, Mr. Ottman.
Check, got it.
Please stand at this time for the playing of the national anthems.
We have our fifth place game coming up next. It'll be Japan and Kazakhstan. Let's meet the teams.
Number 1, Katsuyuki Tanamura, goalkeeper from Tokyo.
Cap number 2, Seiya Adachi. Position number 4, from Gifu.
Number 3, Atsushi Arai. Position 4, from Yokohama.
Number 4, Mitsuaki Shiga. Position right side, from Gunma.
Cap number 5, Akira Yanase. Position center forward, from Kanagawa.
Number 6, Yuta Hemi. Position right side, from Osaka.
Number 7, Yusuke Shimizu. I play the center, and my from is Kumamoto.
Number 8, Yuki Kadon. Position right side, from Mie.
Number 9, Koji Takei. And position left side from Kyoto.
Number 10, Ken Yasuda. Position quarterback
from Ibaraki.
Cap number 11, Keigo Okawa. Position number 3, from Yokohama.
Number 12, Atsuto Iida. Position number 3, from Aomori.
Number 13, Tomoshi Fukushima. Goalkeeper, from Kagoshima.
Head coach Japan, Yoji Omota.
Number 1, Valery Shlimov, goalkeeper from Kazakhstan.
Number 2, Sergei Gubarev, forward and from Kazakhstan.
Number 3, Jardan Maxim, forward, Kazakhstan.
Number 4, Medvedev Evgeny, forward, Kazakhstan.
Vladimir Ushakov, forward, Kazakhstan.
Number 6, Alexander Gedovnyuk, defender, Kazakhstan.
Number 7, Murat Shekenov, forward, Kazakhstan.
Number 8, Anton Kuliadenko, central defender from Kazakhstan.
Number 9, Rustam Okumanov, forward from Kazakhstan.
Number 10, Vedish Yulian, central attackant, Kazakhstan.
Number 11, Ravil Manafov, center forward from Kazakhstan.
Number 12, Branko Pekovic, center forward, Kazakhstan.
Number 13, Mahmet Madikhan, goalkeeper, Kazakhstan.
Head coach, Kazakhstan, Sergei Markovic.
And our fifth place game about to begin here. It'll be Kazakhstan taking on Japan. Kazakhstan here in the white caps. Japan in the dark. And Japan looking to claim fifth place here along with Steve Carrera. Greg Meskel here with you. Of course, Kazakhstan looking to do the same. And we touched on this yesterday. And the one advantage here to finishing in fifth, if by chance one of the top four decided not to attend the World League Super Final, you could be the next one up. So a reason to win here for both Kazakhstan and Japan, and especially for a Japan team here, Steve, that I think might be the most impressive, of course, depending on what Brazil does here in the final, but the most impressive performance coming out of the week, just a team that had really come a long way in the last couple of months even to be pretty competitive here.
Yeah, I mean, they're really showing that they can play with some of the best teams in the world, and I think both of these teams did not expect to be in this game. I mean, I think they're Japan and Kazakhstan are both overachieving, if you will, in their placement. So it's pretty exciting to watch these two teams play.
And Japan will take control here. We talked about the contrasting styles here. Japan now fast up on the counterattack here. We'll have a look. Nice save there by Valery Shlimov, the keeper for Kazakhstan. Katsuyuki Tanimura going in net. 14 Japan. And on the counter here, Kazakhstan the other way. And an exclusion called. Pekovic is dragged down from behind by Mitsuaki Shiga.
And that's one of those situations where you take the kick out on purpose, slow the counter down, and then you got to play your man up defense. Better than a one on nobody.
Kazakhstan a little bit more traditional style, bigger team, a little more center play out of them. Japan up and down, fast, looking to get on the counter attack. Almost would rather prefer not to be in half-court offense if they can avoid it. Sides come even here. Shot clock about to expire for Kazakhstan, down to four. Outside attempt, beauty of a shot, cross cage, Godovanayak off the post and in. It's a 1-0 lead for Kazakhstan.
And right out of the gate, Japan was open on the counter. Didn't convert, and that led to Kazakhstan going down on an open counterattack to this 6-on-5 goal. And this is just unblockable, really.
I mean,
bar in.
It's a tough one to stop right there. So Kazakhstan takes the 1-0 lead with a minute gone by here in the first. This is our fifth place game coming up at noon. We'll have Team USA taking on China, and then we'll close it out with the gold medal match, Australia and Brazil, right here at 1:30.
And we've seen a lot of movement from Japan in the last couple of days in the front court set.
Nice steal there, Kazakhstan. Alexander Godovanayak coming up with the takeaway. He'll look ahead. Here's Jardan. Pulls it out.
Japan really wanting to press out, trying to front 2 meters. They have good position right now. See how long they can hold it.
They're definitely undersized here against this Kazakhstan team. Ukamanov, beautiful one-on-one maneuvers, but a save, Tanimura. Ugamanov able to tip the ball to himself to work around the Japanese defender, but a save there by the keeper.
So far, Kazakhstan's been able to really slow down their counter the last couple of possessions.
Ordinary called. Japan being pressed back. Now looking into 2 meters. And they'll draw an exclusion. This will go against Pekovic. Power play here for Japan, trailing 1-0. 5:45 to go in the first.
Remember, if you watch the Japanese game.
Beautifully done. Yusuke Shimizu rising up to put that one away and tie things at one.
If you watch them, Japan really like to go inside on the post, and you saw a perfect example of that. Got a left-hander on the inside left post, which is not a typical place to put that player. But I mean, I think we've said it all week. I mean, they're really unorthodox. To try new things, and it works for them.
Anything but typical, right?
Yeah.
So each team scoring a goal here to get us started. 5:25 to play in the first. Japan with their customary pressure here. Looking to generate turnovers. Pekovic steps back and misses wide of the cage. And Japan will take control. You see Tanimura anxious to get that counter ball. They're ready to go.
Yeah, I mean, they're going to be up right here.
Here's Kodono moving in, left-hander unguarded. Lob try and a beauty, puts it away, Yuki Kodono, and Japan has scored two straight to go ahead 2-1.
A nice little counterattack, you know, patience, fakes it a couple times, and that lob shot, that's been a go-to shot for a lot of teams this week.
And Japan, crafty as well with multiple left-handers out there that can do some things on offense. We've seen a couple of lefties score to start here with Kodono and Shimizu. And they're going to give a check here on Japan for too much sunscreen. That was number 5, Yanase, getting checked over by the official Haas Ortega, the American referee in this match. For as sunny as it's been all week, it's only the second time we've seen a sunscreen check.
Yeah. I'm not quite sure how much that really affects the game. It's always been sort of a silly rule, to be honest.
Well, if someone really had it lathered on, they could be pretty slippery there at 2 meters, right?
Yeah.
An exclusion here against Japan. Number 2, Adachi going out. And here's Kazakhstan on the player advantage. Couple of fakes. Gubarev, and he misses left of the cage. Tanimura let that one fly by. .425 to go, first quarter. Japan a 2-1 lead. They've scored two straight here.
And Kazakhstan now in a drop. Yeah, you know, leaving one guy open up on the top. He's going to walk it in right now.
Shot clock to 5. Tough angle, but better if you're a lefty. And Kodono puts away his second.
And that was tough because the defender on the wing went up, leaving the wing player wide open. And even though it's a tough angle, when you're lefty, you know, you have more margin for error right there on the right side of the pool.
Still needing a pretty precise shot, and we'll get a second look here at Kodono picking up his second.
Japan really coming out strong here against Kazakhstan.
Gubarev working down low. Ordinary. Under 4 to play here in the first.
And this is what Japan does best. They're able to press without fouling.
Entry inside. And a takeaway. That was Pekovic looking for a call. The ball comes back to Tanimura. He has a smile for the referee, and Japan takes control with 3:38 to play in the first.
And they're up again here, 6-on-5 counterattack.
Japan again pushing the tempo. Looking inside, beautiful pass. Shlemov with a great save as that was point blank for Yanase. On the other end now, here's Ukhamanov. Advancing the ball, working inside, spinning, shooting, and scoring. One-on-one maneuver by Rustam Ukhamanov, getting rid of two defenders and putting that one away.
That's a nice way to split the defenders right there, keeping the ball up high so that the Japanese defenders can't get a hand on it and then able to put it away.
Just great awareness of where he's at in the pool, able to make that spin and still come up clean and put it away.
Yeah. This might be a kick out here.
No call just yet. 3 minutes to play here in the first quarter, 3-2, Japan. The look inside, keeper out, and Shlemov and his gamble pays off. He comes over to take that one away.
And you see Japan going back to their traditional press no matter where the players are. I mean, even if they're at half tank, trying to take off as much clock as possible.
Gubarev really battling. Just an ordinary there. Aggressive defense by Adachi. Ordinary called.
And the offense itself is pretty aggressive as well. And so the referee really letting them play there.
Ukhamanov, and that's a penalty called against Japan. Ukhamanov rolled into the defender, let go of the ball, and the penalty is called. And that will go against number 6 of Japan, Yuta Hemi. And a chance here for Ukhamanov in Kazakhstan to tie the game.
If you allow that inside pass and the ball gets in there, you know, inside position, it's going to be a 5 meter every single time. That's a textbook sort of call.
Ukhamanov, big save, Tanamura right off the shoulder. And a corner throw coming for Kazakhstan with 2:26 to play.
Mike McMahon, the referee, with a perfect pass to the other side of the pool.
Strong arm to goal judge over there. 2:20 to play. First quarter, 3-2. Japan dodging a bullet there on the Kazakhstan penalty, but Kazakhstan still with the ball.
And there's that inside position again. Kazakhstan's getting it. They're just not able to get the ball into 2 meters.
Entry inside and tipped away. Defense is there from Japan. Koji Takei coming over. Japan now on the attack. Leaving one player back on defense. And they put the ball away. Score for Keigo Okawa.
Number 12 from Kazakhstan. I don't think he's saying nice things to his teammate for that bad pass into 2 meters. And that's a frustration of, you know, working so hard in 2 meters and holding position and not getting the ball where you want it.
Yeah, he's a little upset. He's voiced his displeasure a couple of times this week. And if you've seen Pekovic out of the pool, you don't want to make him angry, so give him the ball where he likes it.
Yeah. He's still
staring down his team.
Yeah, he's still upset.
4-2 lead for Japan. 1:35 to play here in the first. Dangerous pass there on the perimeter. Japan stifling pressure here, and that entry pass is taken away. Aida comes up with the steal.
And that's the beauty of fronting 2 meters and being able to be quick all the way around. I mean, that was awesome.
Controlling near side, here's Adachi, looks inside. Room to work with, and then an exclusion called as he was feeding Shimizu at around the 2 meter line.
Great patience by the referee there, waiting to see if he was gonna be able to finish that, and then over the head, so it's automatic exclusion.
Medvedev excluded for Kazakhstan, power play here for Japan with under a minute to go in the first. Couple of fakes, loft it near side. Back and forth they go, dropping the pass and the steal by Ukhamanov. So Japan, a couple of passes there in close quarters, and it was tipped away, and they falter on the power play. And Kazakhstan will call for time. 33 seconds left here in the first, a 4-2 lead for Japan. Kazakhstan has certainly had their opportunities. This could easily be a 3-3 game. You look at that missed penalty shot earlier. But Japan stifling on the defensive end and then with their usual sharp shooting from the outside.
Yeah. And Kazakhstan's, you know, they've had their counterattack opportunities that are few and far between, but you need a couple of those in every single game. You need to get at least two or three of those opportunities to balance out your game plan. So I think if they could start getting the ball into 2 meters a little cleaner, a little more consistent, Japan might get into some trouble.
Kazakhstan goes to their bench. Pekovic will return with 33 seconds left coming out of the timeout.
And right away, you could tell they're going to get the ball over here to the right side.
At Gubarev and Pekovic. Here's Gubarev, now breaks free his defender. Powers inside, gives to Pekovic. Beautiful play, but a save, Tanimura. Nice idea. And Japan will call for time with 19 seconds left. So got a good look on the inside there. Gubarev clearly designed play to get Pekovic the ball, but stopped.
The only negative of that was running it maybe too early and giving, you know, Japan now 20 seconds, almost 20 seconds here to run their own play. And, you know, I guess you got to take what you're given, but if you could hold the ball for a couple more seconds and not give Japan so much time, they've shown in the last couple of days that they don't need very much time to score. And, you know, this could be costly for Kazakhstan if Japan converts.
So just 19 seconds left. Shot clock is off here as Japan comes out of the timeout. Fifth place game here for the FINA Men's Intercontinental Tournament.
Might see a little one-on-one drive over here on the left side.
Ordinary called. Let's see what activity Japan works with here. Heavy pressure from Kazakhstan. Nice spin move there from Okawa to break free of a defender. Pushes it in down low, and a takeaway from Kazakhstan with 5 seconds left, and they will run out the time here in this first period. And after one, it's Japan 4, Kazakhstan 2 in this fifth place game. We'll take a timeout and return with the second right here on USA Water Polo TV.
I am
water
polo.
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 I am water polo.
I am water polo.
So, you've got your hard-earned money, but you're not sure where to put it. Well, one of the best things that you can do is put it into a credit union. Credit unions are like banks, only better. They offer higher rates of return, lower fees, and are safe and secure. And because they're not for profit, they're all about putting the people first. With credit unions, you're not just another face in the crowd, you're a member. And credit unions are member-owned and member-operated. Take control of your finances. Visit or contact Sea Air Federal Credit Union to find out all of the great reasons why you should join.
You never know where the next Olympian might be coming from, but it could be water polo, and that starts with Splash Ball. Splash Ball is a program for children ages 5 through 9 designed to introduce them to the sport of water polo while promoting water safety. Improve swimming skills and learn a sport you'll love for a lifetime. For more information, visit splashballusa.org.
Champions aren't born. Champions come from doing what others won't. Because doing their best in this moment puts them in the best place for the next moment. Champions are made. Will. Determination. Greatness. Tear. Get made.
And we're back underway here in the second. Opening sprint controlled here by Kazakhstan. 4-2 the lead for Japan. Here's Gubarev controlling. Steve, Kazakhstan certainly right in this game. They can look back at the opening 8 minutes at the opportunities they have had and just haven't come through on. Where do you see changes they can make?
Well, I mean, I think that they're, you know, you saw the frustration by the coaches and some of the players. I mean, I think they're just passing is not crisp and clean, and they're allowing passes like this to go in on the defensive end.
And that one sneaks past Shlemov. Thought he had a save, but the turnaround from Shimizu goes by him. And it's a 5-2 lead, so I don't know if he maybe took his eye off the ball there after thinking he had to stop.
That was pretty tricky, you know, but we saw this with, as we see the replay here, sort of fakes a front pass and then just wrap around backhand. We saw this with the Canadian versus Japan team just not playing. I'm sorry, Canada versus China not playing good defense on the perimeter. You know, you really have to play good defense if you're going to press.
Here's Gubarev. Being pressed all the way back out to about 7 meters. Here's Ukhamanov near mid-tank with 3 on the shot clock. Looking for a foul and shot. And they run out of time. Shot and clock violation.
That is what Japan does best. I said it before. I mean, they are so good at pressing and not fouling. See a lot of teams pressing, but they're fouling every single time, and that stops the clock and allows them to move the ball around the perimeter.
Five-two lead for Japan. Minute and a half gone by here in the second quarter. A few fakes from the outside. They pour it in, and an exclusion called. With 2 on the shot clock, Pekovic is excluded for the second time.
That's going to be dangerous for Kazakhstan that Pekovic has 2. I mean, he's their main 2-meter guy, and he's going to have to sit the whole rest of this half.
Power play here for Japan. Ball near side, cross cage, save Shlemov. And Kazakhstan will take control. They kill off the power play for Japan. On the other end, penalties called. So Gubarev working hard. Looks like he draws this one against Atsashi Arai. And they'll bring in Medvedev to shoot the penalty.
See if we can get another save here.
And Dunamore with a beauty of a block last time. This time he beats the keeper, Medvedev, putting it away for his first. Kazakhstan converts there, Steve, but both teams struggling on the extra man. Kazakhstan 0-2, Japan just 1-3.
Yeah, I mean, the opportunities are there. But, I mean, credit to the defense and to the goalkeepers, you know, really making it difficult for, you know, for the teams to convert their 6-on-5. Kazakhstan just needs to slow down Japan's counterattack a little bit, be a little bit more patient with the ball on the offensive end. This might be counterattack for Kazakhstan here.
Here comes Gubarev again leading the charge, trying to draw his team within one, and he does. Gubarev on the skip. Goes cross cage, putting it away. It's a 5-4 game, so Kazakhstan battling back here with 2 straight with 5:31 to play here in the first half.
And that was just a steal on the perimeter. Goes down, takes it all the way coast to coast, and able to convert. Those are the types of easy goals that Kazakhstan needs throughout the game, not just to get back in the game, but, you know, every team could use a couple of easy ones, and it gives them an opportunity to really put a lot of pressure on the other team when they're on the defensive end.
Entry pass inside, looking for a turn, and double team is there, taken away. Good of an Ayuk coming over. And a takeaway. So a couple of steals there, and now Japan controlling Tanimura. And Japan again looking to get out on the break. They should be open here, weak side on the move, but now Kazakhstan getting back, still on the attack, and good job by Kazakhstan here getting back on that counter.
Yeah, and Japan had to pull up here at half tank because one of the guys from Kazakhstan stayed back. Japan does a really good job of recognizing that.
Beautiful one-on-one maneuver there from Koji Takei, passing the ball to himself to break free the defense. And then an exclusion called against Julian Verdesh, and a power play here for Japan with 4:35 to go in the first half. Around the perimeter they go, cross cage. Takei is on the board. You saw it, Steve, he waited off that defense. They all collapsed near post and he just went cross cage.
Yeah, I mean, a very nice play there by Japan. And I mean, they're up on the counter almost every time. And Kazakhstan has done a good job slowing it down, but every once in a while, I mean, they're just, you're not gonna be able to slow down every single counterattack.
Takes a lot of energy too. To try and catch up with the counterattack, get in front of it, and then stop it.
And when you're dealing with this type of pressure on the perimeter, you know, they just wear you down.
4:10 to go here in the first half. 6-4, Japan in front. We touched on the last game about the conditioning of Argentina. Meanwhile, it looks like Japan could play another 2 weeks here.
Yeah, I mean, they are just, for four quarters, they're able to swim and counter really, really hard, very aggressive. On the count, they're up again here in the middle.
Under four to play. Here's Japan on the move. That's Okawa, who's been able to throw in some shots from real distance. Shot clock to 8 here. Down to 4. 2 seconds. They'll fire. Save Shlemov. And Kazakhstan takes control.
Right, you see sort of Kazakhstan slowing things down a little bit. Yeah, they really need to get the ball into the center position on one of these possessions here. That takes a little bit of that press defense, a little pressure off of that.
Gubarev working inside, exclusion called against Japan. This will be Adachi going out, that's his second. Kazakhstan will call for time. And they'll get a power play here and a chance to come within a goal with 3:10 to play in the first half.
It was a good timeout here by Kazakhstan, and able to regroup and really try to convert this 6-on-5, which they haven't been able to do over the course of this game. But you know, when they get these opportunities, now that Pekovic is out, it's important to convert. Plus, it puts Japan in that front court situation after goal play, which they haven't been very successful with the entire tournament. Do put Pekovic back in the game, maybe for offense. He's on the two post, which is a very dangerous move with 3 minutes left in the second.
So out of the timeout, here's Kazakhstan rolling the dice with Pekovic, but looking to manufacture a goal here on the power play. Sides coming even now, power play over. Pekovic on the redirect. It's a bar out, and the rebound controlled by Japan, so they had him in there for a reason.
Yeah, and now it's just a matter of him, you know, playing clean defense and not getting kicked out here. That would be devastating for this Kazakhstan team to lose their primary 2 meters man.
Bad pass there from Japan, goes over the top, and an easy takeaway for Shlemov. Entry inside, Gubarev. Exclusion called. Yasuda going out, and a power play here for Kazakhstan.
And that, again, we've touched on this a couple of times over the past couple of days. it's more the strike and how he's coming down with the hand.
There's Pekovic. Comes through with the goal on the quick pass. And it's a one-goal game again, 6-5 now. Japan in front with 1:59 to play here in the first half. Good look there on the beautiful pass. Left-hander gives off to Pekovic. That he stuffs
post.
It in.
Yeah, that two post has been open. They were looking for that the last time. And coach right away subs him out so that he doesn't get that third.
Maybe a little offense-defense here with Pekovic. Bring him in specialized situations.
He definitely didn't want to go out.
Ordinary called. Entry inside. Wave off that shot attempt. First, there'll be an exclusion. It will go against Kazakhstan and Godovanayuk. And a power play here for Japan.
Watch again for that inside post play.
Shot from the outside and a score. And Japan has another Mitsuaki Shiga hitting on the power play.
Nice shot. Very nice shot. I mean, he's up there at about 4 meters. And that's a gimme without a shot blocker in front of him. He's able to walk it in and just take that shot.
Another look here to make it 7-5. A few fakes and cross cage. And so Shiga hitting for his first. With 1:10 left now here in the first half, Japan has led in this one since the beginning. Kazakhstan struck first, and then Japan came back with 2 goals. And since then, they've been ahead. And now it turns over. Looks like one of the players took a shot here.
Yeah, he got hit by number 7 of Kazakhstan pretty bad, right in the throat. And he's shaken up.
And the Japanese coach wondering where the call is. That's number 4, Shiga, who just scored the goal. Now he's over on the side, hanging onto the side of the pool, so hopefully he'll be okay.
And we've seen a lot of, you know, that physical type play, but you know they've absorbed a lot of contact. You know when they're over there on the side and they're kind of taken out, that it was a clean hit. I mean, you know that they're hurt.
Not sure if we have a replay of what happened down there at 2 meters that Shiga took the shot. Under a minute to play here in the first half, 7-5 Japan.
Yeah, and hopefully he is okay, able to return. I mean, that's a good player for Japan, and hopefully things don't get out of control. I mean, the game's been very clean so far. I mean, obviously very physical, but been clean nonetheless, so.
So Japan goes to the bench, and they'll take control here with under a minute to play. And then a takeaway, a steal by Kazakhstan on the perimeter. And now they're off to the races. Here's Koliadenko. They've got numbers. Koliadenko moving in. Deals off. Shot attempt, Tanamura knocking that one down from Jardon. And they'll chase after the ball. And Japan will take over with 27 seconds left in the half. Shot clock is off, holding a 2-goal lead.
I would expect Japan to show some patience here and just run out the clock. If they get a shot, they'll take it, but you know, they'd be content with just not giving Kazakhstan another possession here.
Down to 7 seconds left. Ordinary there on the far side. Outside attempt saved out by Shlemov with 3 seconds left. So Japan may get one more crack at it. Two. They'll go in the corner and won't get a shot off as time expires. We come into halftime, and Japan led by 2 after the first. They lead by 2 again here at half, 7-5. Thanks to 2 goals each from Shimizu, and from Kodono. Don't forget, join the conversation here. Tweet live using hashtag FinaCDM. We'll feature some of your best tweets throughout the day. We'll take a timeout and return with the third right here on USA Water Polo TV.
Water polo.
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 I am water polo.
I am water polo.
So, you've got your hard-earned money, but you're not sure where to put it. Well, one of the best things that you can do is put it into a credit union. Credit unions are like banks, only better. They offer higher rates of return, lower fees, and are safe and secure. And because they're not for profit, they're all about putting the people first. With credit unions, you're not just another face in the crowd, you're a member. And credit unions are member owned and member operated. Take control of your finances. Visit or contact Sea Air Federal Credit Union to find out all of the great reasons why you should join.
You never know where the next Olympian might be coming from. But it could be water polo, and that starts with Splash Ball. Splash Ball is a program for children ages 5 through 9 designed to introduce them to the sport of water polo while promoting water safety. Improve swimming skills and learn a sport you'll love for a lifetime. For more information, visit splashballusa.org.
Champions aren't born. Champions come from doing what others won't. Because doing their best in this moment puts them in the best place for the next moment. Champions are made. Will. Determination. Greatness. Tear. Get made.
USA! 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 Third quarter underway, and Kazakhstan controls the opening sprint as the teams have switched ends. Kazakhstan in the white, Japan in the dark, along with Steve Carrera. Greg Messel here with you from Corona Del Mar High School, home of the Sea Kings and Sea Queens right here in Orange County. And a good look inside, Pekovic on the lob, that's off the mark. CDM, great host this week for 6 days of water polo. And today, if you're on the fence about coming out, you really should. Beautiful day here. Nice little light breeze. Not too hot, not too cold. Entry inside there, knocked away, and Kazakhstan will take control.
Yeah, this has been a great venue over the past over the last week here. I mean, really professionally run tournament. Props to not just CDM, but also USA Water Polo for putting on such a great event and great coverage of all the games. So glad to be a part of it. And whoever's doing all those tweets and Instagram posts.
Yeah, it's our USA Water Polo intern, Hallie Messenger, all over the social media scene. So if you've been following along on USA Water Polo Twitter, Instagram, the kids are into Snapchat these days.
That's what the kids say.
That's all her right there. Here's a penalty. And actually, now just an exclusion is the call. And that will go against Medvedev of Kazakhstan. And a power play now for Japan.
That was quite an aggressive exclusion right there. That very easily could have been a 5 meter.
On the other end, now they swing it around and a goal from Shiga. He goes skip shot, bar down and in. Second look here on Shiga. It's going to come around to him on the near side. He'll bounce this one home.
And that's a really difficult shot. I mean, it may look easy on the screen, but to catch a cross face and then to quickly release without bringing it all the way back, I mean, that's a very difficult shot.
Eight to five now. Japan goes in front here in the opening minutes of the third, battling for fifth place here. Pekovic deals it back out. Koliadenko back into Pekovic. Goalie out, but first an exclusion. That will go against Atsudo Aida. And a power play here for Kazakhstan.
And Pekovic does a great job of holding and sealing off.
And then Kazakhstan scoring with Shakhanov in close on the power play.
This is a nice catch. You know, keeps the ball away from the defense, able to flick it in.
Kazakhstan hanging around. They haven't let Japan totally pull away in this one.
No, I mean, I think Kazakhstan is very much still in this game. I think a lot of it's going to depend on how long Pekovic can stay in without getting his third foul. Because if they can continue going to him in the center, it's creating opportunities.
Tipped away. It'll stay with Japan on the perimeter. Here's Okawa with 12 on the shot clock. Entry inside and an exclusion called. So we'll go against Kazakhstan and Koliadenko, his first. And a power play here for Japan. Near side and a rarity there, a bobbled pass by Japan on the power play as Kodono lost the handle. Sides coming even now. Outside attempt, and that is wide of the cage. Partially blocked as well on the way out. And Kazakhstan takes control with 5:07 to play in the third. Power play numbers, Japan now 4 for 7, Kazakhstan 2 for 5. Entry inside and tipped away. Yanase comes up with the steal.
And that's the situation there. The referee, you have to show that you know where the ball is. I mean, it might be being held, but if you're not able to make a play with the ball, it's tough.
Big save there by Shlemov, and now Kazakhstan will try and get out on the counterattack. Big pressure from Japan, and then a bad pass nearly, but Ukhmanov salvages it. He'll have it on the perimeter. 10 seconds on the shot clock here for Kazakhstan. Entry inside, tipped away and stolen by Tanimura. Coach Yoji Yamoto looking for a call there. And Tanimura will have it back.
And what the referee's saying is he didn't let go of the ball in time. I mean, that's a tough call.
Other end now, Japan strikes. Arai hitting for his first. And Japan pushes their lead back out to 3 now, 9-6 with 3:42 to play.
It looks like a yellow card was awarded to the coach from Kazakhstan complaining about that last no call. But Japan's able to capitalize with a great shot there.
Sergei Markoch given the yellow card, the head coach for Kazakhstan. So 3:40 to play here in the third. Japan in the lead, 9-6. They've led since 2-1 in the first quarter. Team USA coming up next. They'll play for bronze against China. An exclusion here against Japan. Gubarev deflected and then saved by Tanimura.
It's a great save, field block. I think if the pass was a little bit higher, that would have been a sure goal, but he had to catch it low, bring it up high, and then it gave the opportunity for the shot blocker to get there.
Aida, the excluded player, he returns for Japan. Even strength now. Three minutes to go, third quarter. Entry inside, the backhand. And it's tipped away. Japan will track it down. And they'll get a new shot clock here.
Watch out, Pekovic was almost got his third exclusion right there on that one-on-one drive.
Knocked down and taken back by Shlemov. And they'll control it with 2:15 to go. Contra foul. So Pekovic getting tangled up, and it'll come back to Japan now with under two to play in the third.
Very dangerous pass right there.
Ordinary, then a shot, and Shlemov almost found that one trickle through his arm, but he was able to gather it up. Shakhanov now on the move here for Kazakhstan. Looking to stay close in this one with the fourth quarter on the way, trailing by just three. Here's Pekovic, big step to the ball, and he draws the penalty.
5 meter penalty call.
And that one will go against Aida for Japan, and that'll be all for number 12, Atsudo Aida, as he has fouled out of this one. And now a penalty shot coming here for Kazakhstan and Medvedev. See, Pekovic just too difficult for Japan to deal with one-on-one.
Yeah, I mean, that's a great power move. I mean, that's almost something that you want to show the young players. You know, he's stepping back, sealing off, then he steps to the ball, you know, takes the ball and makes that hard turn to the center. Oh, and we got a someone bleeding, number two.
That's Gubarev, so he'll have to sub out for Ukamanov.
And he's bleeding pretty bad.
So hopefully he'll be okay. Coach checks him over.
Yeah, it didn't look like it was coming from the nose. It looked like it was coming from, you know, maybe the mouth.
Penalty shot is scored by Medvedev, his second. He'll have the trainer take a look over there. And Kazakhstan draws to within two at 9-7. Second look here at the put-away.
Kazakhstan realizes that they're not going to be able to go over the head of the Japanese goalkeeper and hitting those corners on the last two.
So Gubarev out getting tended to by the Kazakhstan trainer. Meanwhile, they've cut it to a two-goal deficit with 1:18 to play.
You can't help but think that whatever happened in the end of the first half, you know, the Japanese player got hit, and then all of a sudden, you know.
Yeah, that was Shiga who took a blast to the chest. Good look over the top here. And then a quick turn and a score. Quick move there from Yuki Kodono. Looked like he had an initial look. I think he was dragged down from behind.
Yeah.
He stayed with it, gathered the ball, spun off the defender, and then put it away.
Yeah, that was great. A great awareness.
Has the first look there. He's dragged down, then spins and fires.
Yeah, it almost like he tried to shoot it, and took a second guess, put it down, picked it back up, and fired it. That's kind of that crafty sort of play that you talked about earlier.
Kodono now with a hat trick. Under a minute to play here in the third. Other end, and Pekovic waits off a few defenders. And you get the feeling if they could just consistently pour it into him, he's either going to score or draw something.
Yeah, I mean, that's really the weakness of Japan, is being able to consistently defend the two-meter center position.
Once again, a two-goal game, 10-8. And Gubarev, they got him all bandaged up, and he's back out there.
I'm not sure I'd want him to be guarding me. And you could see it's already being super physical over there.
Guarding on the far side. Entry inside. And then rolled, and that was number eight, Koliadenko. Gave a little something extra to Shimizu on the way out. First an exclusion, and I think maybe a hit to the lower back. So Koliadenko rolled from this one, and you get the sense this may have been happening. Kazakhstan frustrated in this one to begin with. They take a shot there to Gubarev, as that first shot is blocked out by Shlemov. Now just 16 seconds left here in the third, and another exclusion.
And I was watching that the whole way. I mean, number Gubarev is just, I mean, he really is trying to just get somebody. And I mean, I was watching that the whole time.
A save there by Shlemov, killing off the 6-on-4, so nicely done there by Kazakhstan. And then they call for time with just 7 seconds left.
You hope that, you know, for the last, for most of the game, I mean, it's been pretty clean for the most part, and you hate for someone to get hurt in the last day of competition, and, you know, out of frustration. Hopefully they can just keep it cool and play the game, you know.
Now the official just confirming that Koliadenko is done for the match. Not only does he have to leave the pool, he has to leave the bench. But he's sitting on the bench again, so they're going to tell him he's really got to go back into the seats or somewhere else.
We're not just kidding.
No, they're not fooling around about that. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.
Yeah.
Well, now this will be interesting here, Haas. This final, I'm looking at Haas Ortega, the ref, Steve. His final 8 minutes, the officials Ortega and his partner will have to really keep an eye on the physical player the final 8 minutes, make sure there's not any additional cheap shots.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, watching number 12 and number 2 from Kazakhstan, I'm not saying the Japanese team is innocent, but, you know, these guys are really playing physical positions.
Pekovic just launched his defender out of the way, and they got a clean look, but it was over the goal. And a timeout called by Japan with 3 seconds left. So they'll draw something up here for the final 3 seconds. Ahead 10-8. Get a good look there at both coaches.
Japan has shown over the course of the last couple days that they do not back down. They do not back down from physical play. They can be physical themselves. And really, it's frustration for some of the other teams when you have somebody who's just all over you, pressing you the entire time. You know, I think it's a frustration start to boil over.
And now they're removing Cole Hidenko further from the area. He was still wearing his cap sitting in the stands, so now they have him with his cap off. And here, 3 seconds left now for Japan as they'll make things live, already grappling on the perimeter. And here's Okawa to put it in with 3 seconds left. Entry here, and Ordinary, here's a shot coming. And a save, Shlemov. And that knocked out with less than a second to go. Literally 1/10 of a second here remaining. As Japan will put this one in play, and that'll bring an end to a feisty third quarter. As Japan holds a 10-8 lead over Kazakhstan, 8 more minutes to go here in this fifth place match. So come back and join us for the fourth right here on USA Water Polo TV.
You never know where the next Olympian might be coming from, but it could be water polo. And that starts with Splash Ball. Splash Ball is a program for children ages 5 through 9 designed to introduce them to the sport of water polo while promoting water safety. Improve swimming skills and learn a sport you'll love for a lifetime. For more information, visit splashballusa.org.
Champions aren't born. Champions come from doing what others won't. Because doing their best in this moment puts them in the best place for the next moment. Champions are made. Will. Determination. Greatness. Tear. Get made.
Fourth quarter underway here in the fifth place match. And it's Japan 10, Kazakhstan 8. Steve Carrera and Greg Meskel here with you. Our third place game coming up, Team USA will be taking on China for the bronze. And then it'll be Australia and Brazil for the gold. All those four teams have already qualified for the FINA World League Superfinal coming up in Italy in June. Here's Gubarev. See, he has his face taped up there. Took a shot to the grill in the third. Entry inside, Pekovic. Whoa, and Pekovic just upends Okawa. Almost a chicken fight here as he lifted him out of the water. Now Japan takes control.
Great ball movement.
Lob try just off of the post and the rebound controlled by Shlemov.
Great ball movement by Japan. Moving the ball, I think four different players touched the ball in that possession. Weren't able to convert, but great shot opportunity.
Here's Ukhamanov. Minute gone by here in the fourth. Shot clock to 5 for Kazakhstan. Looking over the top for Pekovic. It's tipped away. And Japan comes up with it.
That was a very risky pass. I mean, obviously they didn't convert. It's 3 guys right there.
On the other end now, Japan looking to attack. Minute and a half gone by here in the fourth. Outside attempt, entry in. Quick turn and a score. Out of 2 meters, the quick spin from Akira Yanase. And Japan pushes it back to a 3-goal lead here with 6:23 to go in the fourth.
I haven't seen very much of that 2-meter play, natural goals out of the center position from Japan. That was a great addition to their game. The help did not come fast enough for Kazakhstan as we see the goal again skip right underneath the goalie's arm.
Kazakhstan on the attack. Ukhamanov being pressured by Shiga on the perimeter. Again trying to set up Pekovic. Goalie out, but first an exclusion.
Able to convert. It's a great opportunity.
On the other end, the counterattack is there. Japan, Hemi to Shiga. He connects for a hat trick and a 4-goal lead for Japan, 12-8.
Now that's what we talked about earlier, that the exciting fast break type water polo. You know, I mean, it's when you're able to counter that quick, and then, I mean, he just basically redirected that thing with his fingertips. That was awesome. That was a great goal.
So Japan's gone ahead 4 here, quickly moving to 12-8 with 5:50 left here in the fourth. Entry inside, goalie out. That's a mistake, but they luck out as Pekovic goes off the bar and out. And now Japan on the move. This is where you're seeing some of Japan's physical fitness, Steve, as it's a lot of up and down water polo, and they are still out on the attack and scoring. Yuki Kodono has 4 goals, and Japan's starting to put this one away now as they have expanded to a 13-8 lead. This is a 2-goal game after the first, second, third. Here in the fourth, Japan taking control.
Yeah, like you said, I mean, it's the conditioning. They look as fresh now as they did in the start of the game, and Kazakhstan is running out of gas. I mean, there's only so many possessions that you can have going into 2 meters and not converting, or the 6-on-5. It takes all the energy out of you to be able to do that, and they cannot finish. They're not finishing at the point of attack.
Here's Gubarev working inside. Ordinary called as he's pressured there with 8 on the shot clock. Under 5 to go in the match. And they run out of time on the shot clock. And Japan will take control, and Coach Omoto likes that, clapping it up as his team moves into the offensive end. Now Japan can take some time here. Or attack, entry inside, and they draw a penalty. Found Shimizu working inside, and he draws the penalty on Shakhanov. And a chance for Japan to add on another with 4:33 to play. Save Shlemov, so a big stop, and if Kazakhstan has any thoughts of coming back here, that was a must-have.
Yeah, that was a great block, way off of his line, the goalkeeper. But they're going to have to convert one of these great entry passes that they've had. They've had the opportunities, no doubt about that. They just haven't been able to put in the goal.
Ukhamanov, Gubarev, he goes cross-cage and puts it away.
A lot of options on that. I'm sort of surprised he didn't pass that ball, actually.
Yeah.
Try to take matters into his own hands, maybe.
Yeah, Pekovic was going to be wide open right in front of the cage. But either way, they score the goal. A Under four to play. Fourth quarter. Japan and Kazakhstan here going for fifth place. Entry inside, double team. Vukhomanov is there.
And Japan continuing with the pressure on the perimeter, and that just is killing the shot clock for Kazakhstan, already down to 10 seconds.
Entry inside, Gubarev spins off the defender, tries the push shot. The stop, but the follow is there. Pekovic working hard, and he's got a hat trick. Second look there, Pekovic. And credit Pekovic, he's stayed in this game a long time carrying two fouls.
Yeah, I mean, he got a second ejection with, I want to say, like 6 minutes left in the second quarter. So, been able to really capitalize and play smart defense. What a great drive right there.
Drive through here for Japan. Trying the backhand was Okawa off the bar.
That was a great one-on-one drive.
Tanamura comes out to make the steal. And Japan will take control with under three to play.
I feel like Kazakhstan had to have that possession right there.
Trouble here now with Japan on the counter. Bad pass over the top. Touches the end line. So Kazakhstan gets a reprieve there. They'll have it back now with 2:37 to play. Trailing by three, they'll have to score just about every time down. Here's Gubarev. Looks inside Vukhomanov. Tanamura out, comes up with a steal. And so the keeper, Tanamura, coming up with some big steals.
Yeah, great coming out. And Japan just continuing to push the counterattack here. Might get one more, seal the deal.
Cross cage, Kodono, he's got five. And Japan, another. 14-10 with 2:14 to play as Kodono goes over the arm, cross cage of Shlemov.
Yeah, that's a really deceptive shot because it almost looked like, I think the goalkeeper was thinking skip cross cage, and he went high, went right above the arm. Japan with a great showing here at this tournament, and you know, they look like, I mean, obviously I don't know birthdays, but.
Other end, Pekovic, he's got a four. That's not too bad.
And I think what was really impressive, again, was just being able to get a little bit more center play today, drawing some exclusions, 5 meters, just a couple natural goals. But these little one-on-one drives, and then the dish into 2 meters.
That one off the post. Much to the dismay of Takei, who was waiting there to celebrate it going in.
Those little crafty drives are really what gets teams into trouble.
Big steal there.
One on
Shiga comes over and just knocks down Vukhomanov. And now here's Takei. He'll go in for a leisurely swim. Put on the brakes. A couple of big fakes and puts it away. And Koji Takei connecting for his second, and he'll put this one to bed. 15-11. Japan now in front with a minute 19 to go.
And just unfortunate turnover for Kazakhstan in the front court leads to this one on nobody, and not very many people at this level are going to miss a shot like that. So, like I said, a great showing by Japan. And Kazakhstan. I mean, Kazakhstan had a great tournament as well. I just think Japan was in better condition. Kazakhstan couldn't keep up for all four quarters. They were doing great for three, but it caught up to them.
Dangerous pass there on the perimeter. Nearly taken away. Kazakhstan will control it. And we're under a minute to play here in the fourth. Japan on their way to fifth place. here at the FINA Men's Intercontinental Tournament. Backhand, Gubarev, Tanamura with the save. It'll come back into Kazakhstan at 2 meters. They'll hold on the perimeter under 50 seconds left. Nice day by Katsuyuki Tanamura. 6 saves, 4 steals. You can look past the 11 goals allowed, of course. Bekovic throws that one high at the cage.
Yeah, I think those the 4 steals, you know, really that type of aggressive goalkeeping really reminds me of Garrett Danner from UCLA. You know, really just cat-like. Always out trying to find those steals, trying to anticipate, find the open lanes. He's really good at that.
Here's Pekovic, 2-on-1 here. Ukamanov cherry picking. He'll jam it in. Well, and Danner, probably a little bit bigger here than Tanamura, but similarly, not gigantic guys, you know, if you're talking about a McQuinn Barron type person. So a little bit more mobile out of the cage can be that person that leaps out from the net to try and play aggressive.
Yeah, I mean, in all honesty, and I've known Garrett Danner for since he was, you know, in age group, 12 years old. He's probably one of the most athletic, just pure athletic kids in water polo. I mean, he is, I mean, I understand the size thing, but it to me, it's a little surprising that he hasn't been given an opportunity to sort of show what he can do. I mean, he's won an NC2A championship this year. He's a solid, solid player.
About out of time here. Final horn sounds. That lob doesn't find a home, but Japan does the job. They take this one 15-12 over Kazakhstan. 5 goals for Yuki Kodono. And Kazakhstan, Steve, led 1-0. After that, it was all Japan, and they did enough throughout in what was a physical third quarter, especially to outlast Kazakhstan.
Yeah, I mean, a very, very well-conditioned team, Japan, and they kept the press and the pressure on for all 4 quarters. They never stopped, and that really wore down Kazakhstan, with Kazakhstan missing some easy ones. And, Japan really impressed this tournament, so congratulations to them.
Japan takes 5th, Kazakhstan 6th, the final 15-12. Coming up next, Team USA will meet China for the bronze medal. We're going to step aside for now. Steve Carrera, thanks for spending some time with us on the mic this week, chipping in on the color commentary.
Yeah, no, thank you always for the opportunity. I love being a part of this, and thank you guys, USA Water Polo, and all the crew here for making this happen. I know a lot of people are tuning in, so it's awesome to be a part of.
So we'll step aside now, and we'll come back with the third place game coming up at noon. Stay with us right here on USA Water Polo TV.